Hi, I am Bernadine Louis, Director of the Virgin Islands Studies Institute here at H. Lavity Stoutt Community College. Monday, 17th of October, will be celebrated here in the British Virgin Islands as Heroes and Forefathers Day. This is the second year that this holiday will be celebrated since being approved in December of 2020 for the list of public holidays and first celebrated in October 2021. The goal being to recognize important Virgin Islanders of the past. So one may ask, what is a hero and who do we consider as heroes and forefathers? The term hero comes from the ancient Greeks and it is normally ascribed to those persons who have done something so beyond the normal scope of human experience that they have left an unforgettable memory or legacy behind when they pass on. Many persons whom we recognize as heroes and ordinary people doing extraordinary things. Recognizing the persons who have made the Virgin Islands what it is today should be the essence of our Heroes and Forefathers Day. Today, we are in the Hamilton Lavity Stoutt Memorial Room, a mini museum collection that was created to honor the first Chief Minister of the British Virgin Islands for his stalwart contribution to the development of this territory. Hamilton Lavity Stoutt was born on 7th March 1929 to Isaiah and Idalia Stoutt of Longby in Tortola. He attended the Western Methodist School at Zion Hill and later the then Senior School. On leaving school, he studied house and boat building with Mr. Wilfred Smith, but also engaged for some 15 years in wholesale and retail business with Mr. A.D. Watts. His brilliance and knack for business was astounding, and in no time, he went from an ordinary employee to the foreman and finally as the top manager of A.D. Watts & Company. As you deal with people, people get to know your abilities, and people have always been my business, he said. His people skills made him a good candidate for the 1957 elections, which he contested, and won his second district seat at the age of 28. He won again in 1960 and 1963. He was propelled to the international stage, however, when in 1967, with the first election under the 1967 Constitution, he won his second district seat again and was appointed the first ever Chief Minister of this territory. Join me now as I share a bit about the work of this Virgin Islander who is considered a national hero and visit his Wall of Fame, which captures the major projects that he and his members of the governments spearheaded during his long tenure as the Chief Minister. On the Wall of Fame, we have many of his major projects, including the opening of the Central Administration Complex, which is in the heart of Rotown. We also have projects that he did for Jos Van Dyke, including Great Harbor, the renovation of the entry, the port of entry. He also spearheaded many health services in the territory, clinics. And in this one, he is here with members of his government in Jos Van Dyke again, at the opening of a clinic service. He did recreational facilities. Here, he is shooting a ball at the newly opened Benjamin A. Rumney Recreation Complex at the time. We also have on this wall his baby, the groundbreaking at the college grounds here at Paraquita Bay. At the time, it was called the BVI Community College. But by 1993, when the buildings were completed, it was renamed H. Lavity Stoutt Community College. When asked, or when chided, well, why is it called H. Lavity Stoutt Community College? His response was, who else? Who else?
should it be named after.
Here he also opens the crochet pair, and he was also instrumental in introducing the Social Security scheme. The first recipient of the Social Security scheme, which he introduced, stands here with him in this photo. Honourable H. Lavity Stoutt also traveled widely, and he visited London. He has visited so many international places in Europe, the Americas, both North America and South America. He was a true statesman. In this photo, here he is with his deputy chief minister at the time, also the late Honorable Ralph T. O'Neill. Unfortunately, this was the only graduation that he was able to attend in 1993, because unfortunately, he passed in 1995. If you will note at the top of the Wall of Fame, we have his famous quotation, his famous saying, "Where there is no vision, the people perish. Where there is no vision, the people perish." And from the multiple projects and development that we see on this Wall of Fame, Honorable H. Lavity Stoutt was a man of vision. We call him a visionary leader. We will now move over to a little more information about the man himself in terms of his family life, both his birth family and his immediate family. In this first exhibit, we have photos of his birth family and also artifacts of his time with his immediate family. Here we see his mother, Mrs. Rachel Ann Idalia Stoutt, she's deceased, and his siblings. He was the eighth child, but one of his siblings, Honorable Prince Stoutt, was also a legislator like his brother and served in one of the governments along with late Honorable H. Lavity Stoutt. So they were both legislators together in the government at one time. We have artifacts from his family members, his daughters and his sons, giving him various cards as signs of affection during Father's Day, Christmas, and other times of the year. We also have evidence of his rich spiritual life, his church life. He was a Methodist, a member of the Methodist Church in the British Virgin Islands. He was a lay preacher and he was also a Sunday school teacher. And here on display, we have copies of some of the sermons that he would have prepared. We also have, this is a copy of a project, a building fund project that he spearheaded for the West End Methodist Church. Under politics, Honorable H. Lavity Stoutt was a hero, certainly in the political arena. In this exhibit, we have his last appointment in 1995 as the chief minister, and he's here with the then governor, Governor Peter Penfold. I noted on his appointment letter the many subjects that he was responsible for. I looked at that and I said, that was a huge responsibility. I mean, there are many subjects that fell under his portfolio. We also see in this exhibit some of his musings, his thought process as he conceptualized the different projects and so on through the years. And so we were happy to get this sample in his handwriting, his own handwriting, of his thought process as he put together proposals for various projects. Honorable H. Lavity Stoutt was also a very effective statesman. He traveled the world on behalf of the British Virgin Islands. And this exhibit, this cabinet, depicts some of the many persons that he met during his travels. Here he is with the now late Queen Elizabeth II on one of her visits to the Virgin Islands. A very young Lavity, Hamilton Lavity, I may say. Here he is in the bottom one with his colleagues in Legislative Council, leading his government in the debate. And this cabinet depicts a lot of the industrial development projects that he would have spearheaded. Again, the social security scheme, recreational facilities, health clinics, and some of the members of various organizations and so on that he would have consulted with to ensure that these projects came to fruition. H. Lavity Stoutt is with his team here. The groundbreaking of the H. Lavity Stoutt College. He's here with members of the first board of governors. When the late Honourable Hamilton Lavity Stoutt died, he died in office in 1995, and the entire country grieved. He was a visionary leader, a nation builder, someone who was trusted and who embraced all Virgin Islanders and residents as his people. He's remembered each year, as I pointed out previously, on the anniversary of his birth, which is a public holiday in these islands. He's always fondly remembered for his motto, which is the title of his Wall of Fame, "Where there is no vision, the people perish." There are many others we know who also give selfless and courageous services to this country. And names that are often called are Mr. Noel Lloyd, Mr. Theodore Faulkner, Mr. I.G. Fonseca, Mr. Carlton De Castro. The last three being honorable members of former legislative councils. And there have been others since Honorable H. Lavity Stoutt. The goal of the Virgin Islands Studies Institute is to document the contribution of all who will be declared national heroes so that our children and their children will know and appreciate on whose shoulders we stand.